gentlemen, girls and boys, welcome to this year's prep school musical, Baba Yaga. A very Russian tale of deceit, cunning, bravery, suspense, and an evil witch who is very... Don't give the whole plot away.
Sorry.
Before we start, we ask that you make sure your mobile phones are turned off.
Or at least on silent.
And please refrain from flash photography.
It really is very off-putting for the actors.
So without any further ado,
we give you Baba Yaga!
cast that we've given her.
Again, we really are sorry about the casting decisions.
Nobody knew about the magical dog that helped her and was her one consolation in her miserable and lonely life.
Oh, darling, darling, oh, darling, darling, what a wondrous story you are.
There she is, the little sly doll singing to herself again.
Oh. You call that thing that sounds like it's just a whale. Mummy, she's it to me! Mummy, she's it to me!
Now, now, Gertrude. It was much more like a strangled cat.
The despicable ugly sisters and their evil mother had grown increasingly jealous each day of Vasilisa's blossoming beauty and hatched a wicked plan to dispatch the unwanted child once and for all.
Vasilisa's father was away on business.
Goodbye, my darling wife, and good luck, children. I'll follow business.
Bye! And the stepmother had moved the family to a cottage on the edge of a dense birch forest, a long distance from any town or village.
During the afternoon, the stepmother and her daughters had been round the house blowing out all the candles, and they now approached Vasilisa at dusk as she was preparing the evening meal.
Do you find it a little dark in here, Vasilisa?
Yes, Mother, a little. Please go and fetch a candle from upstairs.
Go ahead. But it won't provide much light, I'm afraid. Silly girl, I asked you to tend to the wicker bow's candles.
But I did. I don't understand.
You never do, you brainless child. Now go into the woods and fetch your light. I have a relative living in that forest by the name of Baba Yaga. She will be most forthcoming.
But it's nearly nightfall. How will I find my way in the darkness? And besides, I've heard stories of the sorts of things that can be found in this forest. Snakes and spiders, ghouls and goblins, werewolves and witches.
Witches indeed. What an imaginative child you are. You'll have to tell us about all those witches when you return.
If
you return.
And so Vasilisa set off into the forest.
Watch out!
And so Vasilisa wandered through the forest the whole night long, knowing neither where she'd been nor where she was going.
Then after several hours, she heard the sound of distant hooves approaching from the east.
The young girl realized to her horror that these stilts were not stilts, but giant chicken legs. As if noticing her presence, the legs extended, doubling the height of the house, revealing the feathery thighs that had been obscured under the hut. Realizing that this was a witch's house, Vasilisa turned to run.
I smell a human. Even better, a child.
Come here, sweetie.
So scary, her chin so airing. light and white, but first you must complete some little tasks for me.
You're not going to hurt me, are you?
Oh, I'm not going to hurt you. I'm going to eat you. Ha 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 ha! Come with me. Open wide, my dear friend.
And so they travelled through the gates, under the birch tree, past the dog and the cat. The path they walked down was lined with scars, their eyes all lit up a fiery red as the two went by and into the cottage.
Just how will Vasily suppose? Must I? Point.
Okay, Grandma, but didn't you tell me it was impossible to escape?
Exactly! long before your time, little girl.
Okay, I'll bear that in mind. I'd like to ask you about the horseman. Who is the white horseman who rode past me in the forest?
That was Dawn. I drive Dawn.
And who is the red horseman?
That was my servant. My reckless son. My high noon.
And who, may I ask, was the black horseman?
My servant. My black dark knight. Why don't you ask some more questions if you're so very curious?
No, I'm fine, Grandma. I don't want to end up knowing too much and growing too old before my time.
Very well, but I should rather like to ask you a question. How can you manage all those tasks? Who helped you?
Vasilisa hesitated, not wanting Baba Yaga to know about the doll.
My mum's blessing helped me.
Ah, good bark!
And then senseless by Vasilisa's answer, the witch rode off speedily in her mortar, broomstick, leaving Vasilisa to retire to her room, confused and wondering why the witch hadn't just dumped her up there and then.
Yeah, James, why didn't the witch just eat her? It doesn't make any sense.
Don't ask me, James. I didn't write it. Anyway, there always is some mystery in these trashy tales. Just wait for the finale. It makes it less sense.
Yeah, fair enough. I suppose you're right.
In any case, Vasilisa realised that this was her one chance of escape. She got out her faithful doll, gave it all the remaining bread, and then sat patiently as she listened to as the doll told her all she must do to escape. Don't worry, you're not meant to be able to hear that.
Just before nightfall, Vasilisa crept to the window and waited, holding a sugar lump in her hand.
Rising early before the dawn, Vasilisa crept outside, the doll secure in her rucksack. She furtively tiptoed down the path lined with skulls.
Her first obstacle was the cat. At first, it snarled at her and made as if to scratch her.
But she took a dried sardine out of her sack and gave it to the cat. The cat purred and rolled over. She stroked it and it purred again. And it let her pass.
The next animal in her way was the dog. It snapped and barked at her, all foaming at the mouth. It looked for all the world like it would bite her viciously and tear her limb from limb.
But Vasilisa took a bone out of her sack and threw it to the dog. The dog eyed it up, its tail wagged, and it panted for joy. He seized the bone and began tossing it around, sharpening his teeth on it, rolling around on the floor, and generally having a great time. Vasilisa gave the dog a pat on the head and let her through.
Baba Yaga has never given me a bone.
Then came the birch tree. As Vasilisa approached, it cocked its branches backwards, ready to release a tremendous blow to Vasilisa.
But Vasilisa produced some red ribbon out of her sack and wrapped it round the tree. The tree relaxed its branches and said with a loud voice,
"Thank you, Vasilisa. Abba Yaga has never in the last 50 years tied my branches even this straight, but you have with ribbon. I love it. You may go past. Good luck, little girl."
Feeling slightly alarmed by the fact that she'd just been spoken to by a cat, a dog, and now a tree, Vasilisa moved onwards to her final obstacle, the gates. There were huge, heavy, imposing gates that appeared to sneer as they recognized the little girl.
But Vasilisa produced a bottle of oil from her sack, and the gates almost seemed to sigh with pleasure as Vasilisa lubricated their hinges. Never in their entire life had Baba Yaga given them even a drop of oil, and now Vasilisa had emptied the entire bottle. The gates duly opened and let Vasilisa through.
But before leaving, Vasilisa picked up one of the glowing skulls from behind the path and put it in her sack. She was sure that this magical skull would provide more than enough light for her evil stepmother and sisters.
It was now almost morning and the dawn roars could be heard approaching from the east.
To stay awake, just under Baba Yaga's window.
Thank you. grandmother and family are about to get their comeuppance.
Happily ever after.
And it was all thanks to...